Direct from Cobo Center in Detroit, the Auto Channel presents complete video coverage of the 2007 North American International Auto Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2007 Chevrolet Volt Concept.
It's huge because it's a great looking concept car, first and foremost, but I think what's underneath it is, you know, is really the big story. And as we talked about, you know, what does the E-Flex system mean? You know, hopefully that message is clear, but when you can put that kind of system in a car that looks this good, and I think it tells the world very clearly that we understand that this isn't about science projects. This is about creating cars and trucks propelled in an efficient manner that people really want to own, and that's the way you're going to win.
This vehicle is about the E-Flex architecture, and once we get that electrically driven architecture generalized to where we can run diesel electric, fuel cell electric, ethanol electric, gasoline electric, or maybe someday pure electric with no backup source, always using the same basic vehicle architecture, then we're going to save a ton of money. People going into a showroom and saying, I think I'll have the one with the fuel cell this time. I think that's probably 10 years away, but I'm very hopeful that the E-Flex architecture and Chevy Volt is not 10 years away. If that were 10 years away, I'd be cruelly disappointed.
Technologically based vehicles that are intended to get high mileage and low emissions have traditionally been somewhat apologetic, an apologetic face, you know, featureless shapes because of aero and safety concerns. This has all the aero and safety requirements baked in, but we said, you know, why not give it a strong, confident face like a pony car has? So you can feel glad that you're driving this vehicle. You can feel proud of this vehicle. This vehicle has a 40-mile range, so for someone like me, if I use it solely to go back and forth to work and to run a few errands, I would never put gasoline in this vehicle. I mean, you think about it, that's a pretty amazing thing. I mean, an infinite miles per gallon. Bob Lutz joked and said, we better put a sticker on the instrument panel that says, make sure you run the internal combustion engine once every 6 months so the fuel doesn't get stale. But true, it's true when you think about it. Some people are never going to put gas in this car.
Today, people have iPods, they have PDAs, they have cell phones. They have a lot of information that they're carrying with them in these small devices. And so your vehicle has to sync up to those devices. And I think that the coolest thing about it is that you can bring any one of these things into the vehicle, your iPod, for instance, drop it into an area in the vehicle, and your vehicle will sync up to it. The vehicle will recharge it, so you can interface with your iPod through your vehicle interface, which is really important. That's what all vehicles should be doing today, because a lot of people almost live in their vehicles.
For 75% of the customers that drive 40 miles or less, say goodbye to the gas station, and that's like 40 plus trips that you'll have to avoid every year. And the great thing about this is that when you do plug in, it's about a quarter of the cost, 2 cents a mile to get your energy from the electric grid. This is a better idea in that its battery is more advanced than the EV1. You now can put 4 to 5 passengers in your vehicle. You have cargo space. You have a longer driving distance and range, if you will, because you have an onboard engine generator set that takes you from the previous EV1 range of perhaps 80, 90 miles to approaching 650, 700 miles of range. So what we like to phrase it as is the EV1 is something we've leveraged to create a better idea.
You know, we're excited to have GE and General Motors come together on a project that's this big that we think can help revolutionize some of the automotive industry. It's just something we're really proud to be part of. You know, from our side, we were asked to come in and bring solutions that could offer lighter weight, which we all know equates to fuel economy, but also to bring new kinds of materials that could enable totally new thinking for styling and enable the designers to create the wonderful shapes we see on the Volt. You know, another thing that we focused on was the whole environmentally friendly materials. And if you look at we as consumers, the amount of water bottles that we use or soda bottles that we use in a year that are really destined to head toward landfill, the GE Plastics technology team use that as a flow stream to upcycle those materials to now become the hood and the doors and some of the exterior skins of the Volt, which now takes that same application and enables it to be used for 10 or 15 years now in its consumer life.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more automotive fun and information, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.